In this Divi theme tutorial, I'm going to introduce you to the Divi theme page builder, show you how it works and how to get started with it. It's a great tool, but it might not be immediately obvious if you're new to building websites or if you're new to building websites with the Divi theme. If you don't already have the Divi theme, you can get it by using the sponsored link below this video or by going to realwebsitehints.com/Divi. Also, be sure to check out my review of the Divi theme and my top 5 favorite features of the Divi theme. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of building high-quality websites. This video is part of my complete website building course using the Divi theme. In the course, I walk you through everything that you need to know and need to be thinking about when building your website. My course makes it easy by giving you a step-by-step guide with easy, actionable steps so you can break down the task of building your website into stages. I'll help you focus on what the most important things are and what order you should do them in. This video will help you get started using the Divi page builder. If you like what you see in this video, head over to realwebsitehints.com to find out more about my complete course. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we're on the back end of our website. We've got Divi installed. We've got it configured. The next thing is to start building pages and learn how to use the Divi page builder. So to do that, we're going to go over to Pages, and then we're going to go to Add New. And then we've got the general page settings right here. So if you wanted to turn on split testing, which I talk about in the advanced module, as well as just the general look for the page and general page settings like general text color, default, section backgrounds, etc. And then this here opens and closes the Divi builder if for some reason you wanted to minimize it. Then we've got the Save to Library button. So if you created a design here, an entire page design or a section design, and you wanted to save that to use as a template for your future pages, you could click the Save to Library button. And then the Load to Library button will allow you to load either from the Divi library. So there's some pages here that already come with the Divi theme. And then also if you do Add from Library, this is where your own layouts will be, or if you've uploaded layouts, this is where they'll show up. And then we've got the clear layout, which will, of course, empty the entire page. This is the undo button, the redo button, and the see history button. And Divi has also added a bunch of keyboard shortcuts that we can use to help us edit our page. Most of the shortcuts work on the front-end builder, but a few of them work on the back-end builder, and I'll talk about that in the description of this video. So now let's look at this section here, and this is a graphical representation of how our page is going to be built. This blue bar here and this box attached to this blue bar represents a section. And so the main thing you need to know about what a section is a section's all going to have one background color, one background photo behind it. And then inside that section, you can add additional rows. This is a row here. And then inside this green bar here with this white box attached to it is a row. And inside of a row, you can divide that up into different columns. So by default, we've got the ability to do a full width column, and we break that down into sections as small as 1/4 here. If you want, for some reason, to do smaller than 1/4, you can do that by using a specialty section. And then after you've inserted a column, so let's just insert one column here, you can insert a module, and a module is how you add content to your site. So there's this entire library of content here that we can add to our site. Probably the most common ones you're going to be using are images and text. And then if we wanted to add another row below this, we can do that by clicking the Add Row button, just like that, and it'll ask us how many columns we want in that row. And then the settings for the sections and the rows are here with this 3 bars. This takes us into the special settings just for the rows or just for the sections. Now, when we want to add additional sections, we can do that by clicking down here and choosing a standard section. So that's going to add a section just like we already have. We can add a full width section. And now this is a specialty section with specialty modules that are going to be full width to the page. And I think that the main use for this, or what I like to use it for the most, is if you want to have the very top section of your website have one big image with one big title and call to action button that takes up the entire window of your viewer's browser, you can do that with the full width header inside of the full width section. There's a lot of limitations to that. You can't kind of do any sort of design you want to. It's kind of limited, but that's one thing you can do. If you also want to have a special menu, like in the middle of your page, you can do a full width menu. And then the final thing is the specialty section here, and this allows you to do various different combinations. And you can see here we've got one column, 2 columns, and then this can also be broken down into 2 columns or 1 column. This will allow us to add more than 4 columns, actually, if we wanted to. Just click on this,
And then we can insert additional rows like this inside of these columns here. So if you wanted to have more than four, you can do that this way. I generally don't advise. I mean, you generally don't see very many websites with more than four columns anyways. I think it's winds up being too cluttered, so I think four columns is a good stopping place, and that's what Divi did. So let's go ahead, and we're going to just start building a page. So I'm just going to remove these extra sections here that we don't need, and we don't need this row for this. And we're going to go ahead and insert a text module. So we're just going to go and scroll down to text here. And it's a lot faster, actually, with the front-end builder, which we're going to get to in a minute, because you can actually just start searching for the module that you want to use. But right now, I think it's just a good idea to know how the back-end builder works. That way, occasionally, very, very, very occasionally, there's something a little bit weird with the front-end builder, and you might want to just switch to the back-end builder, and so this way you'll know how to use it, and also you'll get a better understanding for how the front-end builder works if you know a little bit about how the back-end builder works. So we're going to make a coming soon page for our website, just so that we can have one page up that's just ready to go with the most basic information about our business on there. So to do that, we're going to go ahead and we're going to leave the text color dark for now, and we're going to change the text orientation to center. You can also change the text orientation down here, and some of these things, like the text orientation and the text color, we can also adjust in the Advanced Settings tab. So every module has got a General Settings and an Advanced Settings, as well as a Custom CSS. So if you wanted to add custom code to a section of your site, you could do that here. But with Divi, it's so easy to make modifications. There are so many settings. You don't really need to add custom CSS to make a great-looking site. So let's go ahead and we're just going to type in the name of our business, Beachtown Surf Shop. And let's make this a headline tag. So we're going to make it a larger text and using a HTML heading tag, and that's what we can do by just clicking here, just highlighting the text, and then just clicking there. And if we want to view what this looks like on the front end of our website when we're on the back end builder, we can just click this little eye icon right here. It's going to show us what this section on the front of our website looks like. It doesn't show us our whole page, it just shows this one section here. All right, that's great. So now let's do save and exit. What's important to know about the save and exit button here is that that just saves it on the page while you're editing this page, but it doesn't actually save the whole page. So to save the whole page, you either need to click on the save draft button here, this publish button, or after the website's been published, the publish button will turn into a save button also. And so when it's in save draft mode, it's not visible to our viewers who aren't logged into the website. It's only viewable to us, and when we click the publish button, it's live on the web. So let's insert one more module, and we'll sort of give another line of text. We'll center this also. So your source for custom surfboards and surf and surfboard repair. And we'll go ahead, and now we can view again just to see what this section looks like. We go. Let's make this a little bit bigger by giving it an H2 tag here, and then we'll click save and exit. Now, some of the things we can do with the text, if we want the text to be larger on the front end of our website, we can click on the Advanced Settings tab here, and then since we've gave that a headline tag, we can use this header font size and just make it a little bit bigger, and then we can preview it here. Make it a little bit bigger even. All right, that's great. Save and exit. So now let's go ahead and start working with the front-end builder. So the first thing I want to do is save this draft so that we don't lose anything, just in case when we switch to the front-end builder, we don't want to lose anything. Probably won't, but I just like to be safe. Just save early, save often. And let's go ahead and click on Use the Visual Builder. Okay, so now we're here on the front end of our website, and you can see there's the text that we added, and now we can see these various different colored highlights that pop up. So the blue represents sections, the green represents the rows, and we can adjust the columns by clicking on this column button here, and then the gray represents the modules that are inside there. So we want to add a new row here, we can just click on the green button, do a full width row, and let's go ahead and add a email opt-in form. So we're just going to click on this. And let's give this a name. And you can see as we're typing here, the text is being added in. We can see what's going on. We can also move this window around so we can get a better view of what our page is looking like and what the edits that we're changing are making. This is really kind of a revolutionary feature for WordPress and definitely for the Divi theme. So the front-end builders are very new to WordPress, and I think Divi is doing an excellent job of making a great front-end builder. And we can choose whether we want to have a background color for this or not. I like the background color. In this case, we might change that later. And then text light or dark, text orientation left or centered. And then we'll just add some more text here. Okay, there we go. And let's go ahead and make this text a little bit bigger so it's easier for our audience to read. So we've got the header font here. Just make that, let's leave that about like there. And of course, this is going to change depending on the size of the window that your viewers are using, so you want to keep that in mind. And then let's also adjust the body size, make that a little bit bigger like this. And we'll click check here. So now let's look at the settings for this section, and let's give it a cool looking background. So we're going to click on this little gear icon here, and then now we're looking at the section settings. So we've got the general settings, and we can add custom CSS, and we're going to add a background image. So we just click on upload here. I've already uploaded the image, but if you wanted to upload it from your computer, all you do is you click on upload files. You can either drag files from your computer onto here, or you can select files and then just click on it right there, and it'll upload it. And I've already optimized this picture, and if there's a video in the course on how to optimize your images, it's really important to do that to make sure that your site loads quickly for your viewers. Let me go ahead and select this. All right, and there we go. So I got this image and just about all the images that I used in this course from unsplash.com, and I've got a link to Unsplash and this particular image in the description below, and also on my website, realwebsitehints.com, I've got a post that shows you various different places where you can find free-to-use images for your website. So now we've got a background image for our web page. Now let's go ahead and continue to make some modifications here. So let's add some space up here above and below so that we can see more of the picture. So to do that, we're going to click on the plus icon here to add a new module. And the module that we want to add is the divider module. So you can just type in div, and it pulls up the divider module, and we can give it a height. So I'm just going to give it a height of 100 to start out with. And you can see that divider module came in between our title of our shop that we put in here and the sort of tagline that we put below that. So to move that, we just mouse over to the gray box where the divider is, and we just click on that cross, and we just drag it up above. There we go. And then we can duplicate this just by clicking this little icon up here that looks like sort of two boxes on top of each other. That'll make a copy of that. And we can drag one of them down below there. So now it's filling up more of the screen and starting to look, you know, kind of fun and interesting. So you can see how easy, and once you understand what the back-end builder is doing, how intuitive it is to use the front-end builder. One of the cool things that Divi has, too, is the ability to use keyboard shortcuts. So if we want to save our progress so far, which is always a good idea, save early, save often, so you don't lose anything, you just push Command or Control S, just like you would doing anything else. And you can see down here it says Saving Draft, so it's saving this page right here. And then down here at the bottom, we can actually open and close this, and this is sort of the general page settings here. We can also view what this page is going to look like on a tablet by clicking the tablet button here and on an iPhone. Divi does a pretty good job, as you can see here, sort of doing optimization by itself. So in a section of this course later on, we're going to talk about how to optimize your pages for use on different devices to make sure that all of your users, no matter what device they're on, are getting a great experience. Okay, so let's add a background to this section here, or to this row here, so that we can read this text easier. We're going to make it sort of slightly transparent section. So to do that, we're going to go to the row settings. Right here, you can see how it highlights the row right around where that text is. We're just going to click on settings. We're going to click on design. And we're going to add a background color just by clicking here. So I'm going to choose black, and we're going to change the text to white in just a moment. Can already see a problem there, but we're going to fix that. We're just going to drag this down till I get a semi-transparent header like that, and we're going to click OK. And let's add one more section here, just like this. Do one row, and let's drag this up here to the top, and let's move our divider into this so that it's separate from where our text is. And you can do that. You can just move things between rows just that easy. And now let's change this text to be light. Let's change this text here also to be light. So there we go, looking pretty good so far. And let's just add one more section right below this, and we'll just put in our address. So to do that, I'm just going to go ahead and duplicate this row here, since we've got all the settings already in there. It's actually a cool function in the Divi theme. All of the keyboard shortcuts, which I was mentioning earlier, if you just push the question mark button, you get this shortcut that will show you all of the keyboard shortcuts that you can use when you're using the front-end builder like this. So if you use Command-Z, it'll undo, Command-Y will redo, etc. So just really a bunch of really cool features, and as you get to know the Divi builder, you're just going to get faster and faster at building pages. And features like this really help. Just go ahead and drag this section here below our sign-up box. Let's see here, we've got that divider in here, so we'll add in one more section here with one row. Move that down below. And then we'll move our... Oops, it didn't move. Okay, we'll move our divider into here. Move our divider into here. And then we'll move this section down here. There we go. Okay, so now let's put in our address and phone number. You can actually edit text just by clicking into it, just like this. So we can go... And then if we don't like editing like that, because right now, as when I push enter, it's going back to the standard size, which is actually probably what I want. You can just click the, you can just push the escape button, and that's going to take us out of that text editor that's sort of live on the front end, and we can click on the gear icon, and then we can go back and use the visual builder here. So let's change all of this. Let's actually use an H2 tag here. So... And then we'll just type in our address. And then to make all this text same size, I'm going to go ahead and just change that to an H2 tag. And click check. And then we'll use this to modify our phone number. So you can just click right in and you can start editing right here. So there we go. Now we've got a really good, nice looking splash page that we can use while we're building the rest of our site behind. Now the one problem is that we still have our title and menu bar up here, and since we don't want our visitors clicking around on our site since it's not finished yet, we want to go ahead and change that so that title bar doesn't show up. So let's go ahead and save our settings here. And then we can either click on Exit Visual Builder, or we can just click right to Edit Page. And then what we need to do here is to change the page template down here from default template to blank page. And the blank page is going to move the header area with the menu section. And we can click on update. So now our page is live. And then we can go ahead and view the page by clicking view page up here. So there we go. So now we've got no menu up here, just the menu because we're signed into the back end of our website. So these are our editing controls. If we signed out, it wouldn't show up. So there we go. So that's an introduction to the Divi Builder and how it works and how to sort of start using the front-end builder. If you're browsing around on your site and you want to start editing a page, all you got to do is just click on Enable the Visual Builder up here. And you can go ahead and just start editing your page again. And then you can just exit the Visual Builder. I definitely recommend saving before you exit. There is a warning that comes up sometimes to remind you to save your page when you've made changes, but it doesn't always work. Like right now, it didn't work, for example. So it's always a good idea. Just click on this button down here. It opens up the page settings, and then you can click on Save over here in the bottom right to save your changes, and then exit the Visual Builder. So in the next video, we're going to look at how to use Divi page templates and how to quickly and easily build a page that's been pre-designed for us using a page template.
I hope that you found this introduction to the Divi theme page builder helpful. If you'd like more guidance building your site with the Divi theme, be sure to head over to realwebsitehints.com and check out my complete web design and website building course. For more tips, tricks, and reviews to help make building websites easier, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and visit me at realwebsitehints.com. Thanks for watching.